Hello and welcome to another episode of China Teacher Brand, where I share with you what it is like to live and work in China. Today, I want to continue with the video series about living in China with an electric vehicle. And today, I want to talk to you about how to get a home charger for your electric car. But before we do that, a lot of people are saying that you guys are paying me money to make that video. I'm like, no.
很多人都会觉得他是我们未来花钱买来充值的一个广告人，但是不是的。
I made the video because I absolutely love the car. It's the best car I've ever owned.
Thank you.
Let us start talking a little bit about some of the arguments that I hear a lot on YouTube and the internet related to the limitations that the EV market has in China because people don't have access to, well, home charging. One thing that these people don't understand is that the EV market is divided in two. You have people that have been using internal combustion engine cheap cars for work. So you got your taxis or your deliveries or people who need to do short commutes in the city and they don't have very high paying jobs, but they get cheap internal combustion engine cars. These people, if they live in cities where the government has decided not to issue any more licenses or to issue car licenses only based on the lottery, it becomes almost impossible to get a new license for a new car. So what option do these people have? Well, they go and they switch to a cheap electric vehicle. Most of the sales of electric vehicles in China are of this kind. Not many people are buying NIOs or Teslas or Audis or Mercedes-Benz. So it's important to understand that the growth of the market sits there in the cheap electric vehicles. You can think of, for example, in Shenzhen, the blue BYD taxis or the DD, which is sort of like the Uber here in China, or Tao Tao. It's a similar company. Most of these cars run on electricity. So all these people, they live in places where probably they don't have access to a parking spot or a home charger. So they rely on a large, vast network of public electric chargers. And the government of China and some private enterprises have tackled that challenge and that need already. There's plenty of electric chargers all over the country. Now, it's worth thinking then about the other part of the EV market, the people who are buying high-end electric vehicles, for example, the NIO, or for example, the Porsche Taycan, or the Teslas, right? These people are a very different market. They are more likely to have parking available for them to install a home charger. So the limitation for large companies like Tesla, NIO, Porsche, and Audi, and all these new players in the high-end EV market doesn't really exist, because most of these drivers, most of these owners don't rely on the public charging network. We only rely on public charging network when we need to go on long trips. So for example, on the highway, we will require fast charging. But other than that, most of the owners of these kinds of cars will be able to have a charger at home. Let's talk about what is necessary for a buyer. Well, the first thing that you need is, well, the owner of the home has to contact both the management and the power grid company. In my case, I rent my home, so I had to talk to my landlord and tell her, hey, I want to buy an electric car. Can you help me to, well, liaise with all these parts so that I can get it installed? It is very, very simple. So they arrange for a scheduled visit from the power grid company and the management of the garden, and they will, well, the gated community, and they decide where they're going to install the meter, the counter. An important thing here, they will give you two different electric bills. You will get a bill for your normal utilities at home, your fridge, your heater, your air conditioner, and a separate bill for the charging of your car. But let's move on. So together, management and the power grid are going to decide where they are going to place the meter. Why is this an important thing? Most car companies, car dealers, they will offer you a certain amount of wiring for free. In my case, NIO offered me 30 meters for free. So when the power grid came and they said, well, you need to put your meter over here, it was about 40 to 45 meters from where I needed to have my charger. So I was a little bit disappointed at that, but hey, anyway, it's a free charger. I might as well pay 100 RMB more just to get it installed where I needed. So everything was all and done. So they gave you a certificate and then you go to report to NIO. NIO is then going to arrange for a visit from their technical team to see that all the requirements for the equipment are met. But I had a little bit of an issue before that happened. Well, the power grid company said that they wanted to install the meter right next to a neighbor's parking space. And that neighbor complained to management. She said that for whatever reason, she didn't want to have it there. So basically the power grid had to come back and move it to another place. All this in coordination with management. And lucky me, they moved it to an area that was about 20 or 25 meters from where my car is normally parked. So I ended up having it for free. So let me remind you here, both the power grid company installation of the meter is free, and also the moving to another place because of this neighbor's complaint was also free. And now because I was closer to my parking space, I didn't have to pay extra for my wiring. So I'm a happy EV driver. So once the NIO team is satisfied with the requirements of the wiring that the power grid has done, they will send a request for, well, your charger. Now, NIO sales in December had been so high that there was a little bit of a delay in giving me my charger. So I actually had to charge in public charging stations a couple of times. I only got my charger about 10 or 15 days after I received my car. So basically they call you and say like, hey, it's here, it's ready, we're gonna go and install it. You don't have to be at home, the car doesn't have to be there to test anything, they just need authorization to go into your garden, into your gated community, and they will do the installation, and that's it. It's only two visits by the NIO team and you're done. They will explain to you how it works, so let's talk about how to charge at home. For that, you're gonna need your phone. You're going to open your NIO app. In my case, this is what I explained to you. And you scan the QR code on the charger. That is going to connect both the charger and the car via the app. Now, whenever I remove the nozzle from the charger, the charging port in my car is going to open. Let me remind you that there are two ports in this car. There's a slow charging port on the left and there's a fast charging port on the right. We're going to talk about the fast charging port on another video because that's the one that you said fast chargers in public places. So let's talk about the slow charging port. My car takes about 6 hours to charge from 0 to 80%. And when you consider the fact that you can schedule through the app what time your car is going to charge, be it you want it from 0 to 80% or 0 to 100%, if you're going to go on a long trip, you can schedule all those times pretty much like you can do in many other cars and many other manufacturers. But another thing that you can do is you can coordinate with the power grid company and they will tell you what time is the best time to get the lowest rate. So for me, this is from midnight until 6 o'clock in the morning, and the rate that I'm getting is 0.27 yuan, which is, I don't know, like 20 cents per kilowatt. So for me to charge from 0 to 80% will cost me, sorry, to 100% will cost me around 21 renminbi, 21 yuan, which is again like $3 more or less. Now, another feature of this charger, which is quite interesting, these four pieces of the car are connected: the charger, the car, the app, and the key fob. So if the key fob or the phone are near the car and the charger, you can unplug the nozzle and you can charge no problem. But if the key fob or the phone are not near the car, you can't do that. So it is protected that way. Nobody can park another NIO next to my charger and use it, for example. Or if I'm charging and I'm sleeping, nobody can come in the middle of the night and unplug my car just to be mean to me, for example. These things are locked and protected by, well, the app itself or the key fob. The same happens in public charging places. If, for example, I'm charging at a fast charger and I go to a Starbucks to have a cup of coffee, somebody could be mean and just, hey, I'm gonna unplug your car so when you come back you're not fully charged. Well, since the key fob and the phone are not near the car, it is locked. You cannot remove it from the charging port. So that's an interesting safety feature that you can rely on when you're charging, both at home or outside. Well, guys, that's how you go about getting a home charger for your electric vehicle in China. So if you want to know how to charge in public networks, then you're going to have to wait for another video, all right? That's it for today. Thank you very much for watching this video. And as always, if you liked it, give it a thumbs up. And if you like the content on my channel and this topic, consider subscribing to my channel. And when you do that, don't forget to hit the bell button to be notified whenever there is a new video out. And until I see you again, take it easy and bye for now.